Dear students, today we are going to discuss determination of transport number by Hittorf method. In the last class, we have studied what is mean by transport number and how we can define transport number using Hittorf theoretical device. Transport number is a fraction of total current carried by each ion. Transport number of cation equal to U plus divided by U plus plus U minus. U plus is the mobility of cation and U minus is the mobility of anion. Transport number of anion equal to U minus by U plus plus U minus, and we know T plus plus T minus equal to 1. Now we are going to discuss determination of transport number by experimental methods. Transport number can be determined by two methods, Hittorf method and moving boundary method. In this session, I am going to explain determination of transport number by Hittorf method. Hittorf theoretical device we have discussed. The fall in concentration of an ion around any electrode is proportional to the speed of ions moving away from it. That means cations move from anode to cathode. So fall in concentration around anode is proportional to the mobility of cation moving away from it. This all we have explained in the last class. Now we can write T plus by T minus equal to U plus divided by U minus. That is, here we know T plus equal to U plus divided by U plus plus U minus, T minus equal to U minus divided by U plus plus U minus. So when you are dividing both, this will get cancelled. So you can write T plus by T minus equal to U plus divided by U minus. So we can write like this, U plus by U minus equal to U plus is the speed of cation divided by speed of anion. So speed of cation means it is a fall in concentration around anode. Speed of anion means anions move from cathode, so it fall in concentration around cathode. So U plus divided by U minus equal to fall in concentration around anode divided by fall in concentration around cathode. So we can write T plus equal to, we know T plus means U plus divided by U plus plus U minus. So U plus we can write it as fall in concentration around anode divided by fall in concentration around anode plus fall in concentration around cathode. So it can be written as fall in concentration around anode divided by, here we know fall in concentration around anode and fall in concentration around cathode. So that means it is total fall in concentration. So we can write here fall in concentration around anode divided by total fall in concentration. Now, if we are expressing the concentration in gram equivalents, so we can calculate it as T plus equal to, here fall in concentration written like this, number of gram equivalents lost from anodic compartment divided by number of gram equivalents lost from anode and cathode. So this is the expression in terms of gram equivalents. So T plus equal to number of gram equivalents lost from anodic compartment divided by total number of gram equivalents lost from both compartments. Now according to Hittorf device, number of gram equivalents lost from both compartments is equal to number of gram equivalents deposited on each electrode, because here we have written number of gram equivalents, total fall in concentration or total gram equivalents lost from both compartments. So if one anode, if anode loss means cathode, it will be deposited. If loss in cathode, that will be deposited in anode. So we can write like this also, T plus equal to number of gram equivalents lost from both compartments divided by number of gram equivalents deposited on each electrode. So here one loss means other one will get. So we can write this also like this, here lost also same as deposited, because lost from both compartments, so that will be the same as deposited on both compartments. So T plus equal to number of gram equivalents lost from anodic compartment divided by number of gram equivalents deposited on each electrode. If a copper coulometer is connected in series with the experimental solution, according to Faraday's second law, we know if same quantity of electricity is passing, so it, if the and if the electrolysis cells are connected in series, copper coulometer is connected in series with the experimental solution, so we can say number of gram equivalents deposited on each electrode will be the same number of gram equivalents of copper deposited in copper coulometer. This is according to Faraday's second law. So here we can write it as T plus equal to number of gram equivalents lost from anodic compartment divided by total number of gram equivalents of copper deposited in copper coulometer, because copper coulometer is connected in series with the experimental solution. So according to Faraday's law, number of gram equivalents deposited will be proportional to their equivalent weight. So this also, or this all will be the same. So we can write the denominator like this: instead of number of gram equivalents deposited, we can write it as number of gram equivalents of copper deposited in copper coulometer also will be the same. Now let us discuss Hittorf apparatus. This is the experimental setup of Hittorf apparatus. It consists of two vertical glass tubes connected through a U-shaped tube in the middle. These all are connected with a stopcock, and the U-tube constitute the central compartment that prevent mixing of solutions from both anodic and cathodic compartment. Now these are the electrodes. Electrode is inserted in a vertical glass tube. And here some mercury is placed in the bottom of the glass tube, that is to make electrical contact. The vertical glass tubes and the U-tube are filled with the suitable electrolyte. Here we are taken silver nitrate solution, and now the current is passed for 1 to 3 hours, and 20 to 30 milliampere current is passed through this, and it is connected. This setup is connected through coulometer, copper coulometer, ammeter and resistance. This coulometer is connected in series with the experimental solution. Here this wire is either platinum or silver electrode. This silver electrode is placed inside the glass tube. Here stopcock is there. Then this is the electrolyte. Here silver nitrate is the electrolyte, and the current is passed through the solution for 2 to 3 hours. 20 to 30 milliampere current is passed. Then after the electrolysis, the stopcock will be opened and the solution will be taken from here, and the concentration will be checked. There will not be any change in concentration of the solution of central compartment. So here we know the ions are Ag plus and NO3 minus. So when passing electricity, Ag plus will move from anodic compartments to cathodic compartment and will deposited as Ag. So here two cases we will discuss. One is using platinum electrode and the other one is using silver electrode. So we will know what is the difference when the electrodes one is attacked and when the electrode is not attacked. Now we can write like this: let the amount of silver nitrate after electrolysis at anodic compartment equal to Y. Because here before electrolysis one concentration will be there for silver nitrate, after electrolysis also one concentration will be there. So after electrolysis let the concentration is Y, and amount of silver nitrate before we are passing electricity, that is means before electrolysis, is X gram equivalent. Now we will find out the transport number of Ag plus and NO3 minus. So these are the concentration of silver nitrate after electrolysis and before electrolysis. Now let us discuss the calculation. For the calculation case 1, our electrodes are not attacked. That means we are using the electrode is platinum, and this platinum is intact, that will not attack with the experimental solution. So since platinum electrodes are not attacked by NO3 minus, hence the concentration of Ag plus decreases in the anodic compartment after electrolysis. Let's see this example. This is before electrolysis. Anodic part Ag plus is there. Cathode there is no Ag plus or no Ag. So here after electrolysis what will happen? This Ag plus will move from anode to cathode after electrolysis. So some of the Ag plus move from anode to cathode and is deposited as silver. So suppose if 50 gram equivalent Ag plus was there before electrolysis, after electrolysis some of the Ag plus move to cathode and is deposited there. So Ag plus concentration decreases, that is now for example 20 gram equivalent. So here what happened? After electrolysis, concentration of silver nitrate decreases. Before electrolysis, it was 50. After electrolysis, it was 20. Now, what is the fold in concentration? How much fold? 50 minus 20 equal to 30. This is the same we have written here. Concentration of Ag plus decreases in the anodic compartment after electrolysis. Therefore, Y will be less than X. What is X and Y? X is silver nitrate concentration before electrolysis and Y is silver nitrate concentration after electrolysis. So, here we know after electrolysis the concentration will be less. So, it is Y. Therefore, the falling concentration around anode equal to X minus Y gram equivalents. Let the amount of copper deposited in copper coulometer is W gram. We have already discussed the amount of copper deposited in copper coulometer is the same number of gram equivalents deposited at both the electrodes. We have already told that is according to Faraday's second law. So here the amount of copper deposited in copper coulometer is W gram. So convert into gram equivalent. Equivalent mass of copper is 31.8. So W divided by 31.8 is gram equivalents. So we can write transport number of silver ion TAg plus. The equation is fall in concentration around anode divided by total number of gram equivalents of copper deposited in copper coulometer. So we can write total fall in concentration is X minus Y gram equivalent. Number of gram equivalents of copper deposited is Z. So the answer is TAg plus equal to X minus Y divided by Z. So if we know T plus, we can find it at T minus as T minus equal to 1 minus T plus. So TNO3 minus equal to 1 minus X minus Y divided by Z. So here using platinum electrodes, we have find out transport number of Ag plus and transport number of NO3 minus. Transport number platinum electrodes. Here the electrodes are not attacked and this NO3 minus has no effect on this platinum. Now we will discuss case 2. Electrodes are attacked. Here instead of platinum we are using silver electrode. So silver electrode will attack the solution and we will discuss what is the difference in transport number. Here you see, if silver electrodes are used, the NO3 minus of silver nitrate can attack the silver anode and can bring silver plus ion into solution. Thus, concentration of Ag plus increases after electrolysis. Here we know silver is the electrode. So what will happen? Ag plus will go to cathode. Then NO3 minus will go to silver anode. So what will happen is NO3 minus will move to silver anode and that can bring Ag undergo oxidation at the anode and that will bring Ag plus to the solution. So what will happen? The concentration of Ag plus will be increasing after electrolysis. You understand, students? Here what will happen? Here NO3 minus will move towards the silver, then that NO3 minus will make silver dissolve as silver plus ion, that Ag plus ion will move to the solution. So what will happen after electrolysis, the concentration of Ag plus will be more. That means silver nitrate concentration will be increasing after electrolysis. So we can write it as X less than Y. Y is the concentration after electrolysis. See this example here. This is silver nitrate before electrolysis. Suppose 50 gram equivalents of silver plus is there. Then after electrolysis, what will happen? Some of the Ag plus, surely it will go to cathode. But here silver is the anode. So when this NO3 minus move towards the anode, this Ag will move as Ag plus to the solution. So here more Ag plus will be coming from where? From the anode. So even though Ag plus is moving to cathode, some of the Ag plus will be moving to the solution. So suppose the concentration is 70. So before it was 50, now it is 70. So here increase or decrease? Here it is increase in concentration. So what is the increase in concentration? 70 minus 50 is 20. So 20 is the increase in concentration after electrolysis. This increase happened because we are using here silver anode. So this is the case. So in our example, this Z means 30. This Y minus X is how much? Y minus X? y minus x is 20 only. So this was 30, this was 20. So what is the falling concentration? 30 minus 20, 10. That is same here. Falling concentration due to migration of Ag plus from anodic to cathodic compartment is 30 minus 20. That is Z minus Y minus X gram equivalent. This is the falling concentration. Now, transport number of Ag plus equal to falling concentration from anodic to cathodic means falling concentration at anodic compartments divided by number of gram equivalents of copper deposited in copper coulometer. So here Z minus Y minus X all divided by Z. Now TNO3 minus is 1 minus Z minus Y minus X by Z. So students, let us discuss one problem. Using copper electrodes, a solution was electrolyzed in a transport apparatus. In the anodic compartment, the amount of copper associated with the same amount of water before and after electrolysis were 0.0485 and 0.0522 gram equivalents of copper respectively. During electrolysis, 0.0097 gram equivalents of silver was deposited in silver voltammeter. Calculate the transport number of Cu2 plus and SO4 2 minus. So here what is given, the amount of copper deposited before and after electrolysis is given. That means X and Y is given. X is before electrolysis and Y is after electrolysis. Here we can see X is less than Y. That means because here we have used copper electrodes and the solution is copper sulfate, so the electrode is attached. That is why Y is greater. So here what happened? Increase or fall in concentration. Here concentration increases, therefore increase in concentration after electrolysis we have to find out first. That is Y minus X we have to find out. See the calculations. Amount of copper before electrolysis is 0.0481 gram equivalent. Amount of copper after electrolysis is this much, so X is less than Y. Therefore, increase in concentration of Cu2 plus ion equal to 0.0552 minus 0.0485, that is 0.0067 gram equivalents. Then we know amount of silver deposited in silver voltammeter is given, that is Z is given. How much is Z? Z is given as 0.0097. So we know copper ion dissolved as Cu plus 2 and silver deposited in silver voltammeter is same, as these are connected in series. So total increase in concentration of Cu2 plus is Z. But our actual increase is only this much. So what is the falling concentration? Falling concentration equal to Z minus Y minus X. So Z is this much, Y minus X is given. So the answer is 0.003. Now we know the transport number of Cu plus 2 equal to falling concentration of Cu plus 2 around anode divided by total number of gram equivalents of silver deposited in silver voltammeter. So we can write here falling concentration is 0.003 divided by, this is a silver voltammeter, 0.0097, the weight of or gram equivalents of silver deposited in silver voltammeter. So the answer is 0.31. This is the transport number of Cu plus 2. Now we have to find out the transport number of SO4 minus 2. So we know T plus plus T minus equal to 1. So transport number of SO4 minus 2 equal to 1 minus 0.31. So transport number of SO4 minus 2 equal to 0.69. So dear students, today we have discussed determination of transport number by Hittorf method. Hope the method is clear for finding the transport number. Please like and subscribe for more videos. Thank you for watching.